Hi, hello, welcome everyone to the Vishnu IAS YouTube channel. Today we are going to see another important topic for your UPSC. This will come in your prelims as well as in your mains. You can expect this question in your GS2 polity. Okay, appointment of UPSC chairman by Vishnu IAS team. Chairman of UPSC. So what is there in the news recently is educationalist Professor Pradeep Kumar Joshi has been appointed as the chairman of Union Public Service Commission UPSC. Educationalist Pradeep Kumar Joshi, he was appointed as the new chairman and he is succeeding the outgoing chairman Arvind Saxena, and he will serve the tenure till April 4, 2022, and he is a noted academician and with an exchequer career of heading various state public service commissions in the past, and he is from Almora district of Uttarakhand and he comes from an army background. His father is his father served in Indian Army, and he has completed his education from Kanpur city and he obtained his PhD degree in commerce in 1981 from Kanpur University. So let's see about UPSC. The UPSC is the India's central recruiting agency responsible for appointments to and examinations for all India services and Group A and B of the central services. UPSC is an recruiting board. It is responsible for the appointment and for conducting examinations for all India services and Group A and Group B of the central services. The Department of Personnel and Training. The Department of Personnel and Training, it is the central personnel agency in India, and it is compulsory and it is mandated for the appointments to the services of the Union and all India services. So it is mandated for the appointments to the services of Union and all India services. Okay, and the Department of Personnel and Training is a central personnel agency in India. Okay, it is also required to be consulted by the government in matters relating to the appointment, transfer, promotion and disciplinary matters. Okay, so UPSC, it should be consulted by the government. Okay, by the government, it should be consulted in regarding the matters like appointment, transfer, promotion and the disciplinary matters. And it was established on 1st October 1926 as a public service commission. It was later reconstituted as Federal Public Service Commission by the Government of India Act 1935. Only to be renamed as today's UPSC after independence. So after independence, it is named as UPSC. Actually, it was established on 1926 October 1st as a public service commission. And again, it is reconstituted as the Federal Public Union Service Commission by the Government of India Act 1935. So next you are going to see about the appointments of the to the UPSC. Okay, so as per the Article 316 of the Constitution, the chairman, okay, and the other members of the UPSC shall be appointed by the president. Okay, Article 316 of the Constitution is about the appointment and term of office of the members of UPSC. Okay, so the chairman and other members of the UPSC shall be appointed by president, and in case the office of the chairman becomes vacant, his duties shall be performed, okay, if there is no chairman in this post, okay, for UPSC, then it will be, the duties of this chairman will be performed by one of the member of the commission as the president may appoint for the purpose. Okay, so in that case, president will appoint one person from the commission to do the duties of the chairman of UPSC. Okay, and what is the term of office is? A member of the Public Service Commission shall hold office for the term of 6 years. Okay, they can be in the post for 6 years, on which date he enters upon to the office, or until he attains the age of 65 in case of Union Commission and 62 in case of State Commission or Joint Commission. So whichever is earlier, okay, as per that, their term of office is fixed. Okay, next is Article 318. So what is this Article 318 is? It is about the power to make regulations as to conditions of service of members and staff of the commission. Okay, so the president is empowered to determine the number of members in the commission and their conditions of service. Okay, so president is the person who is determining the number of persons in the commission and their condition of service. Article 319, it is about the prohibition as to holding of office by members of commission on ceasing to be such members. That is, a person who holds office as a chairman shall, on the expiration of his term of office, be ineligible for reappointment to that office. That is, if a person is becoming a chairman of the commission, after the expiration of his term of office, he will not be able to again come to this same position. That is, he is ineligible for the reappointment to this post. Okay, but a member who is a member of the commission, okay, so a member other than the chairman in the, okay, other member, okay, he is not the chairman, okay, a member other than the chairman shall be eligible for the appointment as the chairman of UPSC. So that a person who is other than the chairman, other members of the commission, they can become the chairman. But if a person becomes chairman, again he cannot be reappointed as the chairman. Okay, that is the case. And next is, also the chairman of the state public service commission shall be eligible for the appointment as the chairman or any other member of the UPSC. Okay, so a person who is the chairman of a state public service commission, he can become the chairman of the UPSC, or any other member of the UPSC also can become the chairman. Okay. Next is removal of members or chairman. Okay. So when a person can be removed from this. Okay. Article 317. It is about the removal and suspension of a member of a public service commission. That is, this article 317, it describes that a chairman or any other member of the UPSC shall only be removed from the office by the order of the president on the ground of misbehavior after the Supreme Court inquiry report. Okay. So after, if any person is found guilty on misbehavior, okay, on the grounds of misbehavior, okay, after the Supreme Court inquiry report, the president is the only person who can remove them from the office, okay, by the order of the president only they can be removed. It can be chairman or any other member of the UPSC, they can be removed only by the president, okay, after the Supreme Court inquiry report. And the president may suspend the chairman or also any other member until a report of the Supreme Court is received. So when the report is, inquiry report is getting delayed, okay, he can, president can suspend the chairman or any other member until this report of the Supreme Court is received, okay. Next, we are going to see about the distinguishing features, okay. Let's see what are the features. That is, the commission reports directly to the president. The commission reports directly to the president and can advise the government through him, okay. The commission will be reporting directly to the president and it can advise the government through president only, okay. Although such advice is not binding on the government, okay. And next is, being a constitutional authority, UPSC is amongst the few institutions which function with both autonomy freedom along with the country's higher judiciary and lately the election commission, okay. It is a constitutional body, okay. UPSC is a constitutional authority. Being it a constitutional authority, UPSC is among the few institutions that function both autonomy and freedom along with the country's higher judiciary and the election commission. Okay, that's all. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe our channel, and value added materials will be provided in our Telegram channel. Join our Telegram channel to get info about the daily current affairs. Thank you.